Anyone here? Everyone's gone. People have left now. They've done. That's fine. Okay, this is Surf Soul. So I haven't aped in. I've just been scaling in, as I always do, on spot. I'm not leverage trading this at the moment. I'm not. I should probably, but it's quite volatile, so it's not easy to leverage trade this. I mean, it's looking quite bullish, isn't it? It's not looking weak at all. We've come back into this golden pocket. How did I draw that? Just see how I drew that. I can't remember. Oh, okay. I drew it from there to there. No. Let me just do that to there. Can't remember how I did that. And there, oh, from the top to the bottom. No, that's not a golden pocket. That's not correct. It's the reverse. That's not correct. Sorry, I did that wrong. Let's go to the lower time frame. Let me mark these out. It's good to mark them out. Control value area low, and then we have some high volume nodes here. So you can see that there's one there. There's one there as well. And probably all of this is a big volume node as well. There's some high volume. There's lots of high volume nodes in this range. Back above the value area high. It's come back into this 50%, found support, and we're back above the value area high. Get rid of that now. And look at the daily time frame. So I think that daily open is going to close is going to be quite a powerful level. Let's see where that corresponds with. Just underneath that high volume node there. And the weekly has just begun. 3 day. And the daily is the same place. You see the 12-hour time frame? We have increasing volume, increasing prices. That's quite healthy. That's, you want to see that. That just gives you confidence that as the price is going up, the volume is also increasing. On this 4-hour time frame, we have increasing volume, decreasing red volume. Decreasing red volume. Slight increase in red volume here, but look, it's just reversed, so that's fine too. So for all intents and purposes, it's looking quite good. Looking good, huh? It's looking quite good. Maybe we go for another high. Head to the highs, potentially. Kind of broken this trend line. There's a little bit of a trend line here. As well. There's volume coming in here, look. So the green volume is always quite strong. Bit earlier. That's the problem with this chart. It's really quite early. So there's not really much analysis that you can do except like a volume area. And then look at the candles. You see how we're kind of, I mean, we're at the value area high. We're above a high volume node. It's into resistance. This needs to go up like that. Otherwise, if it struggles here, think it's got some. I mean, it's hard because look, this is going up and then Bitcoin's going down. This is its own beast at the moment. So it's very hard to judge it based on Bitcoin. David said, do TA using Slerf Sol? Oh, not Slerf USD. Okay. Let's have a look. Try that. It's not there. This is all US USD. USD, USD, USD. This USD, it's all USD. Oh, you have to use a DEX. I'm not going to use a DEX. Why? Let's have a look. Buy some Pococa. Search, I can't remember. Use my link. You sent me a link, huh? Yeah, you did. Sorry. David, you're calling me. Is this not it? This is Bowden Soul. This isn't it. Is it? That's not the one. Slerf Soul. Oh, I see. This is against ETH. I mean, look, we just. Find the link and send it to me because I can't figure this out. Okay. I got it, I got it, I got it. I got it, I got it. I got it, I got it now. On radium, I've got it. Made this big. Is that okay? I mean, look at the volume. It's just continuous volume. The whole thing is volume. This is just a whole accumulation range. The whole thing is. I think people are just scaling into this. Some people obviously trading, but it's just non-stop buying, it looks like. Non-stop buying and selling. But this says, this is in dollars as well. Look, this price. Surf against salt. I don't know. Why is it in dollars? So what kind of value area is there? Then we're above this golden pocket area here. Is annoying because I have to do all this. There's no point doing it. Okay, that's better. Now I feel better. Okay, this makes more sense now. Yeah. I kind of prefer the USD chart, to be honest with you. According to this, at 45 is a strong place to buy. Does that correspond with look, that's 79. What is it now? 79. So the prices are the same. Let me see what the value area is. 86. Slightly higher here at 96. What chart am I using here? 15 minutes. It's still the same. Yeah, the volume is on that on this one. You're absolutely right. Look at this volume, 12 million, 13 million, 5 million, 5 million, 6 million. Look at the volume is on this chart. So this is the right chart. You're absolutely right about that. It's hard, I don't know. I don't know what to say. Because look, we're into the value area high. So we're into resistance. You kind of want to buy it lower down. You want to buy it lower down at about the golden pocket or the point of control, which is about 61 cents on this one. On this one, it's about 60 cents. So 60 cents is going to be the best buy, or 60, 61 cents is going to be the best place to buy. They kind of correspond. On the Solana one, the value area high is higher up. So where you have this kind of, there is a little bit of an SR flip then in that case. Yeah. What was it? 9.7. Someone was higher up. Irrelevant. I don't know if it's quite hard to do technical analysis on this, but that's your best buy entry there. And swing failure those lows. That's literally your best buy in this. And then you just do that's your best place to buy this. Back into the golden pocket at about 60 cents. All right. Don't know. I think that's it.